All right, welcome back. Hey, TJ.
Hey, Jen, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, so good.
So
Always.
today we were going to talk about active versus passive income, but I wanted to create a little bit of context for the conversation. So I think tell me if you agree, but it's you're going on along your business a few years, and then it's okay, you realize that all you're doing is just working and then you get paid. And when you don't work, you don't get paid. And then you work and you get paid and you work and you get paid. And for me, I was like, there has to be something else there. And I started off as an investor, but then you read every book and every business book is all successful people have seven streams of income, right?
Yes. Yeah. And this is one of the blessings and curses of being a realtor. It's like we're commission salespeople, which is
Right.
awesome, right? The harder we work, the more money we make,
Right.
which is great until you break your leg, right? Until
Nice.
you can't work. And I think, after that wears off of hey, we can make a ton of money. It's like, okay, but what next? How am I going to prepare myself for success when I don't want to work anymore?
Right.
And
Yes. And
that's
you
kind
have
of
to,
where.
I think people don't realize is you have to start preparing for that now if you're 10, 15, 20, 30 years out, because then it just kind of builds on itself, you know? Because we know a lot of real estate agents and I meet tons of agents who have zero retirement plan, which is fine now when you're 30 or 40 or 25. But at some point, you're going to wake up and be like, oh crap, you know?
Yes. If you ask anybody who's 60 or older, they will all tell you that life sneaks up on you. Like it
Yeah.
does. It's like all of a sudden you're like, oh my God, dude, I'm my parents' age or
Right.
whatever that looks like. And and you and I have talked about this. Like we're always looking for different ways to leverage our time to turn it into money, right? And finding these active ways to make money. But what we were kind of talking about, Jen, is like passive ways to make money.
Right. And I think being in real estate, we have a duty to ourselves. We owe it to ourselves to implement some of the most strategic ways to have passive income. I mean, most wealth, when you read business books, so many wealthy people have real estate as a wealth builder, but so many agents don't have own properties. They might own their personal home, but they don't own other homes.
Yeah, and this is something that you've been awesome at because you've kind of been a house collector while
I
I
love collecting houses.
co collect crypto and NFT. You have actual real things, so that's
Yeah.
very cool. But yeah, and that's something that you turned me on. If you're gonna sell your, don't sell your house. Like keep it as an asset and go buy
Right.
another one. Yeah, but and it can go deeper than that, right? Like there's so many ways now in the current market with the current opportunities we have as real estate agents to make money.
Yeah, but I think maximizing our profession is one of them. And so, you know, the first thing they teach us, in books, is to leverage your time through people, and that's fine. But is that an you have to set it up so that, like you said, if you choose to not actively go after your income, that you're still making it. I think the other is through real estate investing of some kind. And there's so many ways to invest in real estate. You just have to understand yourself and understand the pros and cons of doing that. And then of course other investments, right? But I know for me, and I know for you too, one of the reasons, and we sort of do and sort of don't want this to be an eXp commercial, but one of the things about being at eXp is that we also have opportunities for revenue share and for stocks. And those are really great passive income ways, you know?
Yeah, big time. And well, this is a kind of a cool thing because I joined the company recently, right? End of May,
Yeah.
okay? And I had so many people tell me, like, TJ, it's too late. Like, you missed it. You missed it. The stock already did its thing.
No.
Since I've joined, the stock is up over 50%.
Right.
There's a lot of room to go. We just had awesome earnings. And then revenue share, I'm just touching the surface. Like, dude, we want to be in business with winning agents
Right.
because we all win. Like we all make money. And I really think there's so many agents, if they understood it, it would be like, Okay.
Well, all it is a return on investment of your time. So if you're already doing business and you're already a real estate agent, you need to have like a retirement plan set up. You meet with your financial advisor if you have one. If you don't have one, meet with one, right? They will talk to you about like getting stocks and getting into the market. And we can do that at a discount. So there's no financial advisor that says, if you can buy stock at a 10% discount, they're going to tell you to buy it at a company that you work for and actively participate in. And that's what we have. So they're going to tell you to buy it. Yeah. And then if you're right, I mean, the revenue is a big number. It's like, okay, well, let's look at your numbers. And I think it's something like 95% of the agents at our company do not participate. That's insane to me. If you are an eXp agent, you should participate.
But how cool is this though, right? Because what is the word on the street? Like we all see Facebook, right? eXp, everybody recruits. It's a recruiting
They don't. Company.
Well, guess what, guys? This is like everybody who calls for sale by owners and expires.
They don't.
Nobody does it. So, you know, 1 out of 20 agents with eXp are actively recruiting right now. Like,
right.
This is such a massive opportunity. And like, if it's not for you, that's okay. It's not for everybody, but it's for way more people than realize it. That much I know.
Well, and I think too, like, it's silly if it's not for you. You don't have to actively do it, but make it like part of the process, because you will at some point, to your point, TJ, you will wake up and say, oh crap, I shoulda, coulda, woulda been doing this. If you're a real estate agent and you don't have some type of an investment in the housing market at some level, I mean, there's 1,000 ways, right? Like you can flip, you can do Airbnbs, you can do buy and hold, you can have stock and REITs. Like there's all these things that you can do. If you're not participating in that at all, shame on you.
Yeah. I mean, I think it's important for us to like show the importance of what we do on some level. Like if you're selling the dream of home ownership and you don't own a home, we've got an issue, guys. Like let's live this dream, right? And if we're going to tell people, hey, you can make great money owning multiple properties and renting them out, like
right.
If you believe that, it's so much more authentic and you can speak about it from experience. Like the best, yes, the best salespeople, right?
Well, one of the things that for my rentals, because I do a buy and hold strategy, I'm not a flipper, but what's been cool is that if actually a lot of our clients move into them. So like if we sell people's houses and they like a lot of them, they're not sure where they want to go or whatever. They just want to sell it or whatever. Right. So then they move into the property. But then what happens is we offer, if they then buy with us, we won't uphold them to like the full 12 month lease. We could be a lot more flexible if we're your agent.
Yes.
And so it's kind of just like, it's a great value to people, especially in this market, that are not quite sure what they want to do. They want to be a non-contingent buyer, but they have to sell, you know,
yes.
they don't want to have like a bridge, or they don't want to take advantage of any of that other stuff.
Yeah. It's a major leverage play. And you know, the one thing that I'd want to say to like add on to this that I wish I would have known a couple years ago, it's like, you know, you've got to treat your business as a business, and that means paperwork. You've got to keep track of profit loss, those things, because when you go to get a loan, there's a lot of realtors that like are scared to even do the process because
right.
We're self-employed. Like
right.
There's preparation makes it so easy.
Yeah.
And like there's seasoned agents who do this a lot. Jen's a great one. Like people will help you and you know, we'll help you. We don't
yeah,
care.
We'll
we love to help people.
But yeah. And I agree 100% with you. I think when we're talking to people that are like at their place in their business where they are just realizing like, crap, like this is fine and like this is good, but like there's got to be more than this. Like it can't just be this hamster wheel of work for money. Like there has to be something more. And
yeah.
That's where we can help you, and we can like at least start the conversation and to based on your goals, like connect you with the right people that can help.
Yes. Yeah. Work because you want to, not because you have to.
Yeah. Boom. Yeah.
Boom.
See, there's like even like a pride inside of agents that are like, well, I'm going to work until I die. Well, yeah. But what if you change your mind?
Yeah. And I think a lot of that is like, because I'm so passionate, like, look, I'll be upfront. And I always say this, I work to make money.
Right.
Okay. If I didn't get paid, I wouldn't do it. Now, do I enjoy my job? Most days, but I work to make money, and I work to provide for my family. That's
if we're
it.
Gonna be real, that's why everybody works. So even if you could, like, what if you could have enough passive income through your investments and through, you know, your stocks and your rev share and your whatever, that you could choose to go to work every day. You could choose the clients that you work with. You can choose the location that you work in. Like, for example, I mean, I'm going to Portugal in October because I can. For the month of October, and I'll be working from there, you know, attracting agents from there. And it's like such a cool opportunity to be able to do that, that if we were somewhere else at a different company, we would have to either like pay a lot more or it wouldn't be possible. But then next, I also learned, fun tip when I learned at the bar the other day, that Turks and Caicos, they have British passports. Did you know this?
I don't leave the
country. You're not a traveler. Anyway, you've heard of the Turks and Caicos, right?
Of course, sure.
Okay. Well, they're British passport. They're British citizens, apparently. I need to double check the information, but I didn't know that. And we do business in the UK. EXP does. So I was that's next to my list.
You know what? And I like that you think big. And it's funny when you said that, like, choose who you get to work with. Like, it makes you smile. Like, that's the ultimate freedom, right? Like,
right.
And then you can do this job how you want to do it.
Right.
And you can lead the discussion, and it makes you more powerful on the phone in person because you don't need it. It's optional.
You don't have permission, Brad.
Yeah. So I'll say this, Jen, we've talked about this. Like, we have some big goals with RevShare.
Mm-hmm.
I'd love to, and we don't want to recruit people that don't do business. We want winners. Like, if you guys want to win.
But not a douche. Nice winners.
I'll take the douches. Jen doesn't like that.
No.
I'm just friendly. Yeah.
Yeah. Let us help you. Let's get more return on your investment of time and your investment of money so that you can, like you said, you can make choices. That's it. Choice is the ultimate freedom.
Yep.
Boom, boom. Boom, mic drop.
Love it.
TJ, how can people get a hold of you?
513-379-2000. We'd love to talk.
Actually, and there are a lot of people outside of EXP that own EXP stock.
Oh yeah, I was one of them.
You were?
Yeah, I liked the stock before I liked the company, yeah.
That's so funny. Well, if people want to get a hold of me, my number is 513-400-1691. All right, TJ, thanks.
Thanks, Jen.
See ya.